Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to GameStar TV. It is grand final time here on GameStar TV 1, and that grand final is going to be between Sapphire and John Howard, who we just saw win their semi-final in dominant fashion, as we like to say. My name is Chrisis, and I'm joined on the stream by Lonjanis, our analyst again. G'day, Lon, how's it going?
Geez, don't drop my real name on stream. Nah, that's okay. I don't care. I'm doing well. Really excited for this game after that last game. It was an absolute... It was just a lot of fun, basically. It was just action all the time. Granted, it was really one-sided, but it was really, really exciting to watch, and I'm hoping for more of the same.
Yeah, I don't want to be in the team that played against John Howard, but I really do hope that we have a bit of a stronger showing from their opponents in the grand final, because it was just a little bit one-sided on the part of John Howard. They had a 21,000 gold lead at the 26-minute mark, and that by any means is quite the lead.
Yeah, it was a fairly dominating performance. They garnished, I want to say, small leads, but no, it really wasn't. Overall, total, it was a small gold lead, but they garnished, you know, pretty good, pretty solid leads in every single lane, and then they used those leads like a wedge or a crowbar and just tore the game open. I really enjoyed it. It was a really good way to play the game.
Yeah, it was very, very good. So they'll be going up against Sapphire in this next match, and for some reason, I've got John Howard and John Howard. Instead of John Howard and Sapphire at the moment. Oh, there you go. It was just switching things around. So, yeah, going up against Sapphire. Now, if you've been watching the Aussie Gaming TV stream, you would have seen Sapphire in a couple of games. They were featured in both the quarterfinals and the semifinals on Aussie Gaming TV. So, they've done well to get themselves to the grand final. This will be a very steep test for them, and probably the steepest test that they'll have faced all day, because this has been a single elimination tournament. So it's not as though they're coming into the grand final on with you know, out of the losers bracket, having met up against John Howard's in any previous game. This will be the first time they're taking them on today.
Exactly right. Neither of these teams, you know, have experience playing against each other, really. However, I am completely certain that both teams have a good, you know, chunk of experience playing against each other in solo queue, or dynamic queue, as it were. So we'll see how things go. I bet these guys know a lot about each other, and about their tendencies and things like that. So that's cool. That's a lot of fun. You can see everyone's fairly closely ranked, I think. There's a couple, couple of people who are a bit below, but I'm not sure if that's if they're just stand-ins, or if they're just, you know, underranked, or perhaps on a smurf, or just been lazy this season. Either way, I'm confident Sapphire is probably five good players if they're in the finals, but I know that for a fact about the Liberals over here, John Howard. Individually in the lane phase, every single player was just played it really well. You know, head and shoulders above their opposition from a Halal Snack Pack. Mechanically very sound, all five of them. Again, excellent lane phase. And then they snowballed that lead really well. Again, I haven't had a chance to watch Sapphire today because they've been on the Aussie Gaming stream. And unfortunately, I can't, like, as much as you guys can watch double streams, I definitely can't watch two streams and cast. That wouldn't go so... Well, obviously, it'd be really bad. So I haven't had a chance to see them play at all. I believe they're playing with a sub support today, actually. But I don't think John Howard are standardly a fives team together.
Yeah,
so
they're a pickup team as well. So
I can't really cite that as a reason. This is definitely going to come down to just who plays better, I guess. And I mean, like, on an individual level. So that'll be interesting. Interesting to see if the teams, obviously they did show some macro play last game, but again, it's very easy to play a good macro game when you just crush everybody in the lane phase, you know, all five lanes.
It is indeed. Now, just as an aside, during the match, so from the time that the match goes live, we'll kick off the raffle. And we're going to run the raffle through the first 20 minutes of the first game of the grand final. 20 minutes, and all you need to do is get your one ticket in using the bot. The bot will give you some commands that you can use to get yourself in for the raffle. And during game one, we're going to be giving away a Razor Goliath. So when we set that raffle live, make sure that you get your ticket in. I've been seeing the Aussie Gaming, the Aussie Gaming TV guys have been running a raffle as well, and it's been pretty slow with people getting themselves into the raffle, but they are starting to trickle through there now on the Aussie Gaming TV Twitch chat. Enter that raffle for a chance to win a Razor Diamond back. So that is not to be sniffed at. We're giving away a Razor Goliathus, which, I mean, if you compare Diamondback a mouse to a Goliathus mouse pad, bit of a big distinction. But the other thing that we're going to be doing in game number two is giving away a Razor Hammerhead. So those are the in-ear noise-canceling headphones from Razor. Of course, Razor Arena, a massive sponsor today, and mwave.com.au also sponsoring the AGGN tournament, which we are pleased to bring you. And here on Gamester TV, we do have Plantronics sponsoring the MVP award, which is a Rig 500 HD that's going to go into the draw. You'll be able to win that in June. So I know it's a little bit of a long way away. It's almost a lifetime in esports, but at the end of April, we'll be having a draw for a couple of $20 Riot Points awards. We'll do the same at the end of May, and then the same again at the end of June when we draw the Rig 500 HD as well. So MVPs today here on Gamester TV, they are in with a couple of chances, really, to get their grubby paws on some good old swag. And the viewers, you as viewers, we'll also be able to get your hands on either a Razor Goliathus or a Hammerhead as long as you enter the raffles here on Gamester TV. Now, we went live because all of the players readied up and they actually jumped, they started the game. But unfortunately, wraps disappeared. And the word in lobby chat, Lonjanis, is that wraps has had his power go out on him. So he's back on TeamSpeak. And he'll be back in the lobby again, hopefully soon.
One second.
Yep, he's just jumped in. They're sorting out the order. He's back in his spot in the team list where the ADC might go. So we might be on, ladies and gentlemen, with the grand final of the AGGN tournament. That'll be exciting.
Okay, I just got messaged that in the rules that apparently Sapphire are getting a free win in this match because of the delay from wraps. Apparently they have 10 minutes to start game after the match is scheduled to start, and if the team isn't there, the other side gets a free win.
Wow.
So
we're starting with 1-0 in favor of Sapphire. So that's a nice little advantage.
I mean, like, I guess so. Like, I don't know. I don't know who this person is that's messaging me. Okay, he's saying okay. But all right, so this person wants me he's calling it out. Okay, I believe this is like a manager or a coach or something like that from Sapphire, and he's calling it out, saying that that's what they should get, and he's trying to contact the admin of the tournament to lodge this. So
rightio. Well, I've got a direct line through to the admin, so let me make an inquiry. And I can see at 17:36 it's not 10 minutes yet. So what is the time now? 17:37 here in Christchurch, our studio over here. So all in and ready to go. I think they're going to be able to start the match in time. So I might just take that 1 point away that I updated.
Okay, I mean, look, your call, man. I don't know what's going on. This is just this guy was messaging me trying to contact the admin.
I mean,
so that was a little bit of an odd thing to have happen on stream, but I guess you got to do what you got to do.
Hey, bear in mind, of course, that we are just broadcasting. We are not admins of the tournament, and we don't know. We don't make the decisions. But here we are into the grand final, the best of five. This is game number one with John Howard on the left-hand side, the Liberals going up against Sapphire on the right-hand side. And it actually works out quite well, I was going to say, because Sapphire is on the red team. But, of course, Sapphires are blue. So they'll have to have, at least we'll be going, it's a best of three. So they'll be going into...
You're getting your Pokemon games mixed up, Chrisis. That's all. Right. Sapphire and Ruby.
Oh, that's exactly what it is. I'm a big Pokemon player. As you can tell by the fact I called it Pokemon. Oh, dear. So Grand Final BO5, the ban's
that's all it is. Yes. Yes.
And we got Alistair Trundle, Kindred, and Nidalee knocked out so far.
Kindred's been banned every game. This is the first Nidalee ban I've seen, but if Sapphire or anyone from Sapphire were getting having a chat to anyone watching the games themselves, I can understand wanting to make sure Mediocre Jungler doesn't show back up on that Nidalee. I wonder what their final ban would be. Ryze maybe after last game? It's hard to say. I don't know what these teams know about each other. Arrgh, it's very frustrating for me.
Well, it's a question of them playing against each other, I guess, if they're at the same level. So earlier on today, we had a little bit of a bug that prevented us to see what the picks were. Hopefully, the bug is fully cleared up, and we'll be able to see what Chief Points picks. And just give us a word in the Twitch chat how the sound levels are. If the music is too loud, I'll turn it down. If Lonjanis is too soft, I'll turn him up. And whatever your feedback is, we're happy to hear it. If you want us to do some shout outs as well, we're happy to do so. I'll do a shout out for free to Cenex, who's got the banter going nicely done in GameStar.
I agree with him. There must be a reason that they want Echo banned. Are they concerned they can't actually play it? I'm not sure. Like, I wonder what the logic was with that ban. Were they afraid of the Maokai pick as a counter? But it's not really that much of a counter. It's a strong pick, sure, but odd. Strikes me as odd. But I have to wonder why that...
We saw earlier on that bans and picks were going pretty much to what the common meta was. And if I recall to the last LCS match that I watched, I think Echo was picked several times.
He is, but that's the point. Is the reason it's strange is because why would you use a ban when you're blue side on Echo when you have four, because you get first pick and you can always pick him, right? He has no real counters in lane or anything like that. So the idea is force the other team to ban him or just pick him.
So we saw for a moment there Nautilus getting hovered over, and then Luch decides he's gonna move on from that entirely and pick Fiora, and I wonder where the Fiora is going to be going.
It has to be top Fiora. There's no way that they've picked an AD champ as a solution to Maokai, also because she split pushes extremely well. That has to be what it is. And as for Graves, one assumes it's jungle Graves.
And do you think early on the Fiora is going to be able to get an advantage over Maokai before he gets ahead of steam on and gets to that super tanky, unkillable stage?
It's iffy at the moment. The meta golem, is the build that you would have seen every game both top laners going, makes things a little tricky for AD to actually mess him up, but still actually is a good pick. She does a lot of damage early. Maokai does great base damage too, but Fiora is in a position where she can wait for Maokai to blow his cooldowns and then mess him up. It's just... the thing is, though, I don't know. I need to see how it goes. Maokai can always make TP plays. Maokai has such good ability to help you. If you come gank for Maokai, you're probably going to kill somebody. He's going to point and click snare. No way they lock in Aurelion. So
I was just about to say... that'll be interesting if they do, and I guess if they had locked in Aurelion Sol, it would have been an indication of just how confident they might have felt about this grand final up against Sapphire. Well, it was not to be. Hovering right now over the victor And Jaina, of course.
I like the Victor lock in. Victor has no, like, there's no one who is a super strong counter to Victor. And so the fact that Sapphire have saved their mid pick for last, unless it's a mid Nautilus, which it could actually be. It's probably support Nautilus, but it could be a mid Nautilus in theory. So I like the fact that they chose Victor because he's hard to counter pick. It mitigates the strength of Sapphire last picking their mid laner.
Well, we'll just wait for Blind Turkey to make up his mind. He's got 40 seconds. The team chat would be a very interesting thing to tap into right now. But, of course, we don't have that advantage because we're not in a studio with all of the players. And
that's
we
right.
don't have a whip that we can crack over their heads, as I'm sure happens at LCS events to keep the players in mind.
So something I want to point out actually is the Graves jungle is super, super strong right now in the right hands. And I think he's a very strong pick against the well, I know they picked it first, but anyway, I think he actually will do quite well against the Elise. Elise, excellent map pressure all over the map, really strong ganks. But in a scenario where Graves walks into Elise's jungle, it becomes a lot harder for her to fight him because of his burst, because of the fact that his autos will damage and knock away her spiderlings. She has to land her stun. He has got that dash. He has got such good damage. So I think that's going to be a kind of a difficult matchup for mediocre jungler if the junglers encounter each other.
And do you think that even so, even though Graves' passive is on armor and not...
No, it gives resist. Him MR as well.
Oh, does it give him MR as well?
Yeah, Grit gives him both.
Oh, goodness me. Here I was thinking it was just...
Unless I'm going crazy, but I'm quite confident it gives him both.
So we had a couple of play-by-play casters that were going to be casting with us today, ladies and gentlemen. If you're just wondering what it is about me that I keep making these weird statements... demonstrating a lack of knowledge about some of these champions. We were supposed to have two play-by-play casters and they never showed up. So it was just a little bit weird that that happened. That said, it happened and I am so grateful, Lonjanis, that you are here today because I would be in such trouble.
I don't know, dude. If I knew you were giving away all this Razor stuff, I might have just hung out in chat and gone into the raffle instead of this. Well, I feel ripped off. No, I'm kidding.
we're into
I'm
the
obviously
minute...
having a good time.
Yeah, it's good. We're into the 3-minute delay. It is game one, of course, of the grand final.
I do want to point something out, sorry.
Go for it.
It is actually top Nautilus. It's support Maokai, which I think was a nice little misrepresentation. Nice little way to make it seem like a good flex pick, essentially. What's cool about that is Nautilus is actually a decent... Maokai is actually a decent support. He has a few problems against the Morgana, but Nautilus is much, much harder, I think, to deal with in lane for the Fiora. So I think that's really cool. That may have been an adjustment on the fly. I don't know. But yeah, I think that was really good. Way, way better matchup for the Nautilus. So that's I really got to give it to Sapphire. That was a good little trick play in their draft.
The mind games are coming through from Sapphire. Will it be enough for them to take the grand final? It's game one. It's a best of five. It's actually a best of three. So if you were wondering about things, and now is as good a time as any, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to kick off the raffle right now. For that Razor Goliathus.
Someone is asking, how do they enter?
So I've just made it live in the Twitch chat. Ticket raffle for Razor Goliathus open to all users. Each ticket is one gold star and you can buy a maximum of one ticket. So just by being in the Twitch chat, you earn gold stars. So there's no shortage there. And all you do is you type in exclamation point ticket and then a one to enter and then you'll be in the draw. So I can see Kiln Jake and Senex OCE have all put their names down. Kiln Jake are trying to go for two, but of course you can't get two tickets. You can only get one ticket. It's for a Razor Goliathus, which is a super swaggy mouse
look
pad.
It's a really, really big mouse pad. My housemate has one. And my cats won't leave his desk alone because they just sleep on it. And it really frustrates him. So that's not really an endorsement. But I get the point I'm making is it's bigger than my monitor. Like, I assure you.
So it's nice and big. It means that you won't get RSI because, as you all know, I'm sure, when you move the mouse, you're not supposed to move it with your wrist. You're supposed to move it from your elbow. So you're supposed to be moving your whole arm to move your mouse around. And the Razer Goliathus will enable you to do that. The raffle, of course, is 20 minutes long. So you got plenty of time to get your ticket in. And make sure that you do. If you stick around for the second game of the grand final, of course, we will be putting up a Razer Hammerhead, up a pair of those in-ear headphones from Razer as well. So lots of swag going out to our Twitch viewers today, courtesy of Razer. And thanks to the boys, the team at the Anti-Gravity Gaming Network. Skin battle time. And what do we have? Indeed, so we got five across the top. And disappointing.
Three across the bottom.
Just three across the bottom.
However, the Nautilus and the Sivir both have skins from the same pack. So that's cool. Good for them.
They're both wardens. Yeah, this time, just the one project skin, though. So I kept an eye out for the swanky minions, and I didn't really see them.
No, I didn't think. I don't think they showed up. Actually, maybe it's because it's a custom game and the tournament thing doesn't cause them to show up, or maybe they don't do that anymore. If they don't do that anymore, I'm really upset.
Bit of side boot action coming absolutely in from Elise as well. So. Is that what you were going to say? You loved?
No, I was going to say I love the way that Victor enters the map with this skin, Creator Victor, but. I mean, there's nothing wrong with some side boob, even if it's animated. Whatever works for everybody. I'm not here to judge.
Oh, no, dear. Exactly. So welcome to Summoner Rift. The call goes out. And this is grand final action coming to you on GameStar TV 1. John Howard and the Liberals going up against Sapphire. Of course, they're not actually called John Howard and the Liberals. They're just called John Howard. But we like to call them the Liberals. Of course, you can thank the Liberals for your fantastic internet out there in Australia.
Yeah. Laugh it up. Jed, laugh it up. God damn it, Chrisis.
Well, I mean, if you think about it, that's a pain that never goes away. They're bad in terms of the technology side of things, you know, but the Liberals are huge, heavily focused on mining. So there's a bit of a stretch there from Liberals mining and to gold. So maybe that's why they've gone for it. It's the spirit of John Howard, mining gold all day long. As we see, neither of the teams going for any sorts of invades and nothing really quirky about their setups. Bottom lane on John Howard are going to start off with taking those Krugs. So last time they did this, they had Soraka to heal them up. And now they're just going to rely on good old-fashioned damage management and rotating aggro.
Exactly, which I find it interesting that they chose to do it again. Honestly, the life totals didn't change that much. It just meant Raka, the damage is less split than it was, which that's fine. It's still worth it, but we'll see. They got punished for it last time, and we'll see if they do again. I wonder what ability Maokai started with. Did he start with the saplings, or has he chosen to go with Snare, even the Smash? I have to wonder.
Well, he's got saplings, so...
Saplings? Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah, sorry. No, you're right. He went saplings, so...
Hashtag map awareness from me. all right.
Oh, for a moment there, I thought you said he started with saplings. I wonder what he's going to choose next. And then I thought I was being done.
I wasn't sure what... Good trade, top lane from Chief Points. Getting off both the two Undying Grasps over the course of the fight, the Nautilus only... I didn't check what Nautilus' mastery was. Report me. Anyway, it doesn't matter for now. I'll figure it out during the course of the game. It's probably Undying Grasp. In fact, if it's something else, I'll be shocked. But so I guess we'll see.
Well, we don't have any sort of fancy things that will show you what they've picked like they have on the LCS. Chief Points going up against Drax. Drax has got his shield up, so it's not an exchange as much as a bit of bullying from Drax. But it's really in reply, so they're going back and forth between the two of them. Chief Points Gets his dash forward, gets in range there, knows that he's not really in any sort of danger because the tides are not up.
Right.
Yeah, so he won't get any reply. In the mid lane, Looch, who picks up MVP in the semi-final. Flash coming through from Mediocre Jungler, and it's successfully done. He gets a proc down onto Evil Hag of the red buff, but Evil Hag flashes out and gets himself out of danger that way. So still 0-0 at the four-minute mark with the engage now happening down at the bottom lane. Not really much of an engage. Blind Turkey takes a bit of damage from Raps and gets himself out of there himself. So, yeah, four-minute mark, 0-0, and a tiny, tiny, almost insignificant gold league in lead in favor of John Howard, Lon.
Yeah, you can see Fiora, you know, getting a bit of an edge in the top lane in those Dominions. Same can be said in jungle, but they're not gigantic by any means. So, I find the... Now, this is a really, really standard and kind of dull matchup in the mid lane, by the way, but I find it personally kind of interesting. The reason being is, if you pick Victor, you're going to want to... That's really good synergy with things like the Elise, because Victor, he does much the same sort of stuff as Orianna, right? Good zone control, AoE, you know, CC, decent damage, decent range. On some of his abilities, anyway. And both have good wave clear. However, Victor's much better in the early skirmishes, in short, like, sharp 2v2s, 2v1s, things like that, 3v3s, while Orianna much better in the late game 5v5s than Victor is, because of the, you know, the power of a shockwave, because of the mobility of the ball. So I expect to see Mediocre Jungler coming mid a lot. Either that, or I expect to see Looch, you know, looking to get involved in short, sharp fights early in the game. Because otherwise, Orianna does kind of eventually outscale the Victor. Not in, like, a huge way, but she is better in a team fight than he is.
So, Mediocre Jungler now going, looping around the River Brush that has a pink there that Looch is now going to be clearing out. That'll be the first pink that goes down. Looch baiting Evil Hag right now. In comes Mediocre Jungler. The flash forward from Looch, super aggressive, but pinches there for the counter gank. Evil Hag still surviving. He gets taken down. Drax has arrived by TP, and they're going to look to pick up a kill. In fact, both of the top laners are there, and just as slick as you please, Chief Points and Mediocre Jungle get themselves out of there. No, Pinch has overstayed his welcome. He has to flash away, but the flash follow-up from Chief Points picks up the kill. Drax has arrived a little bit too late, and everybody's here in the mid lane from John Howard and the Liberals. They take down the third kill out of that engage and waltz away with pockets of gold and some good damage as this wave crashes against the turret.
Sapphire may very well be tilted after that. That was enormous for the Liberals. Wow, what a protracted team fight there, protracted skirmish. I guess this is kind of what I'm talking about. In these earlier fights, Victor is much stronger, and I'm astounded that they didn't lose anybody. They came so close, but the timely arrival of the Fiora, followed by the timely arrival of LeBlanc, you know, on Morgana from the bot lane, just right. There's just perfect timing on the side.
And their positioning
on the side of John
was,
Howard and the Liberals.
Their positioning was so good as well. We had Victor getting himself across the wall with the flash as soon as the Graves arrived, and he had taken a massive amount of damage, but it was fine. He walked away scot-free.
Really, really good understanding of how much damage they could take and how long that would last.
Yeah.
Like, you know, when they would need to back out. I completely agree. Now, the level advantage coming off of that fight, I guess, for Chief Points, much he's, you know, level 7 to Drax is, well, now level 6. Look, Pinch needs to start getting a little bit more active. Graves does clear well, but you really... he's not a bad ganker by any means, especially when you've got a Nautilus who has the point-and-click CC of the depth charge, follow it up with the undertow. I really want to see that synergy coming up.
There we go. We got both junglers in the top lane in the brush. A nice little piece of bait work by Drax, but he's now trying to get away. Elise goes up with the rappel and then has to flash away as Evil Hag arrives to support. In fact, both of the mid lanes coming on up there and breaking up the fight, kind of banging each other's heads together and saying, "Now play nicely." and then wandering back to the mid lane.
Good trade, bot lane between the 80 carries. Sivir coming out slightly ahead, but still behind Lucius. The culling coming down. This is getting real violent.
Flash forward from LeBlanc and gets the ulti down. The shackles don't get the root though, because he gets the flash out of both of Eco Toxic and Blind Turkey. So that's not a bad exchange if you're on John Howard. One ulti for two flashes.
Well, I mean, he did lose the culling as well. So it's two ultis
for two flashes.
Yeah, not bad. You can't be too upset with that. Absolutely. Oh, speaking of
underneath
flashes,
the turret,
he's gonna need him.
Turkey takes a huge amount of damage. He got himself bound under the turret and wraps just so aggressive, taking advantage of that. He took a turret hit as well, I think, just to get the damage down. But it doesn't matter. They have bullied the Maokai out of lane. Eco Toxic will have to farm underneath the turret. Lucky for him, he decided not to blue pill. And John Howard, their bottom lane, move on to the Nexus, to the pool, the summoner pool, and do a little bit of shopping, Lon.
Looks like Pinch and Eco Toxic looking for the opportune dragon. In all likelihood, John Howard, no. They did walk through that bush ward, and they haven't seen them reappear anywhere, but they're not in a position to contest, and so they're not going to waste time running down there or anything like that. As we discussed last game, it's not really worth throwing at a dragon. If you're not prepared for the fight, really just let it go
and
most of the time.
It's worth letting it go if you can two-man the Rift Herald at 10 minutes.
And trade back.
So
absolutely. So, well, that depends. The Rift Herald's value can be very high, but they have to make something happen from here. So Mediocre Jungler on the Elise really does need to employ that Rift Herald to take a tower or something for it to be actually a better pickup, in my opinion.
Evil Hag is going to get a little bit more damage there. He's had to move a couple of times to try and get out of range of the ulti that came down from Victor. But he is eventually going to blue pill. But Lucian looking to disrupt things. Nice little positioning there of the blue pill from Evil Hag around the corner so that Lucian didn't have eyes on where he was. Pinch in the mid lane
Pinch
now.
Pinch with the ultimate there to clear the wave.
And just
very
as
early
well
that,
that he did, because he gets himself bound. And, man, it's only the fact that the wave wasn't there to tank the turret, I think, that meant he survived. He had no mana left, very low HP.
Here comes a bit of action onto Raps. He does still have his flash and heal left, but he's not going to use either of them because it would just be a waste. I know, why desperately try to survive when you are still going to die? And I just want to say, Chief Points been really on point. Oh, man, I didn't mean to do that. Chief Points, very, very good this game. Excellent timing with the parries. Been parrying really, really good stuff. Parried the Graves Q before. Oh, sorry, Graves Auto before. But yeah, parrying a bunch of things from Nautilus. Just been really, really good with those. Keep an eye on it. He hasn't mistimed anything so far. He has been blocking what he's been intending to. Just been well done. I appreciate seeing it. The Fiora, it can be a lot of fun to watch in that regard.
In the mid lane, Evil Hag has to flash to get himself out of there, and Mediocre Jungler will not be happy with that play. Oh, he doesn't have... his flash is going to be coming off cooldown now, so actually might be a good long-term play, Longinus, because he's going to be coming into that mid lane with his flash at a time that the Orianna
They're setting up to get the Nautilus, but Maokai's en route.
Oh, the root misses. So Drax, and I shouldn't call it a root because
he says, you know, stick around. It is actually a stun, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, it does no damage, so and therefore it doesn't take tower aggro.
Really?
Yeah, the Elise stun doesn't get tower aggro.
OP.
Well, you have to hit it, and it doesn't do any damage. So.
Oh, I suppose that's the disadvantage. Evil Hag uses his ulti for no real effect. Oh, the ulti, at least with an incredible flash, gets himself out there. He's not going to go down to Pinch's collateral damage. Luch is still alive. Blind Turkey gets rooted underneath the turret. He gets taken down. Mediocre Jungler still up, and Pinch having to run away at the moment. He gets his dash over the wall. He was taking minion damage as well. as up into the air, the rappel from Mediocre Jungler trying to get in range of Pinch, and finally he comes through, gets his rampage by taking down the Graves there. And a 4-0-2 Elise Longinus, you've got to be worried if you're playing against one of them.
Absolutely. Though, look, Elise does have a use-by date, right? She does kind of become a tanky stun bot as the game goes, but that's a little while away now. For now. And he's going off. Really unfortunate for Pinch. When they went for that tower dive there, just, you know, didn't quite manage his bullets quite well enough, so he was sitting there with no rounds in Destiny when they were both there on super low life. It must have been so frustrating. Not enough mana for anything, really. Had already used his ult. Just there, standing under tower, reloading. Must have felt horrible.
Yeah, part of Graves' new kit, I guess. It played against
him. He does work.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Chief points.
You gotta manage that ammunition.
Up at the top lane, Chief points hanging or having a little bit of a hard time against this Nautilus right now. But again, it's Drax, as easy as you please. He hardly changed direction there to dodge the stun. The web going out in anticipation of a flash, I think. That's why it was so far away. Mediocre Jungler is going to stick around in this top lane. They're going to push the turret. And it's
here
got
comes
about
Victor
one
as well.
Third
Luke.
Damage. Victor will arrive, and it'll be 3-1. Drax waddling away there. He's going to get away, is he? Oh,
they
yes, he
shouldn't
does.
Have chased. They yeah. shouldn't have chased. They're giving Sapphire time to get in place. They should have just taken the tower. We'll see if Sapphire can actually get anything done here, but I don't understand why they went for that.
Well, they arrive now. Blind Turkey eats a stun himself, and that puts Paige to their engage. No twisted advance for you, and so
the
all
gravity
they can do,
field.
Yeah, exactly.
From Victor, you chuck him in those choke points, and it's just so very powerful.
And as a result, all they can do is clear the lane after the turret has gone down and have to head away. Blind Turkey might have gotten caught here. The flash through from LeBlanc. He's keen to get a stun down onto Blind Turkey. He might die himself. He's on 200 HP. The chase is on, but the kill comes through because Raps was there. Pops his ulti going down. Pinch right now trying to get away from Chief points, but there's no ways that you're going to be able to do that. And the Fiora picks up a double kill as a result. 10-1 as the 16-minute mark ticks over Longinus. An 8,000 gold lead. And this is pretty commanding for John Howard.
Absolutely. Sapphire have a few things to cling on to. The excellent late-game team fighting of their Orianna, of Nautilus and Maokai, of Sivir. But right now they're getting rolled over. And sure, Elise does fall off as the game goes on. But that's, again...
Oh, Mediocre Jungler! Oh, he dodges, and then he repels. So he dodges the anchor just with some clever play. And then repels out of the depth charge. Gets away again. His mechanical prowess on this Elise is just very, very good. I probably shouldn't
keeping
say
himself
very, very
alive.
Good. Let's
when
say
he
excellent.
Maybe very, very good.
So he's on 502 now, which is he's behind in CS, but he's certainly made up for it with kills.
Yeah, no kidding.
In fact,
that's 6 CS versus those 5 kills.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who cares? Well, it's 10-1 right
that's
now.
That's very much. That's a gigantic lead. They're almost 10k ahead. Very, very, very good for them. But as I said, there are things I can look for Sapphire, but they need to stop the bleeding right now.
Oh, tower dive goes from Chief down from Chief points, and he picks up a kill. Nicely done there. He actually flashed through very aggressive. He's got himself caught out, though, but the cavalry's here. Down goes the gravity well, and in fact, the ulti as well. And that means he gets away again. And the number of times that this happens, tower dive after tower dive, Mediocre Jungler flashing after the pinch. He's going to have to wander out of the main gate. And great anticipation. The ward there doing it in four pinch. And 13-1 is the kill score now. It just keeps racking up. And they're now converting that kills lead into a further turret lead. They've killed five turrets. I mean, we've hardly said anything about it, Lon, because there's been such skirmishes. But five turrets with none in reply.
I feel like when Pinch just came out of that gate.
Luge might go down. He's nursing. 100 HP. Blind Turkey is going to die as well. The kite is great. Lucian has arrived. Wraps off screen. Picks up his double kill. Luge took down the Maokai in turn. And not to be ignored, the little blink, blink, blink from LeBlanc on the Morgana nets themselves their sixth turret kill. And they are... I mean, they don't even have to do blue pill. Yes, two champions have actually blue pill, but at this rate, all that's happening after a red team player spawns is they die again.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure. I feel like Blind Turkey doesn't realize he's playing support Maokai. Not to be too BM, but you don't have the gold and the items to be doing that stuff, dude. You're the support. Stop trying to 1v1 people or chase down like kills on the victor and stuff. He could very well just be out of it. They could just be let's play for fun while we mess around, and then we'll bring it back next game. I don't know, but probably ease up and play a more peel for Orianna Sivir kind of Maokai.
I wonder if Maokai is listening to the stream, because he just put there in all chat, I just wanted a kill, man. And he thought he was in with a chance, but underestimated his champion's power. He did have Orianna in support there, but an excellent gravity well from the Victor meant that Orianna got one ball and one auto attack off, and then Victor was out of range. So very, very clever play there. Blind Turkey not taking no for an answer, though. Heading off to get himself into a world of hurt, giving Lucian yet another kill. Lucian flashing forward, picks up a double kill underneath the turret. He's not going to get his triple kill. The shutdown instead going down going to Evil Hag. But Drax is going to die. Oh, Chief Points gets taken down too. So...
nice little shockwave there by Evil Hag, but a little too late, I suspect.
Yeah, and to be fair,
22-3.
Underneath
this
the turret,
is out of control.
Underneath the turret, where John Howard were extending very, very far. Blind Turkey, man, he's just decided he's going to go for kill after kill. If this was a public, if this was a pub game like normals, people would be reporting him for cheating, I think. Because he's
that
just,
may
he's
still happen.
In.
I'm not sure. Yeah, that was...
he's died six times. We've got an ult, a TP going into the back line from Drax. And he tries with the anchor to pick up Mediocre Jungler. But Mediocre Jungler, well, he's just going to rappel out there. And he's had the timing on that skill. So good over and over. Chief Points going in onto Drax. He's rooted in place for an absolute age. That was almost a Dota-like length of stun from the chain that went down onto Drax. But he managed to get
away. It did seem quite a while, didn't it? I think it's funny that generally when you pick Fiora, she's not four team fighting. She's generally a split pushing pick. But, you know, that doesn't matter. He's just 6-1-5. Just whatever. Let's just group up and crush them with our gigantic gold lead. What is it? 17k? Approximately?
No. Oh, yeah. You're right. It's about 18k. In the mid lane. We've got an engage, another shutdown going on to the Sivir. Another shutdown now. The red team picking up a little bit of a gold bonus as Blind Turkey arrives. I think the main feature of those kills was that Blind Turkey didn't initiate them because he wasn't there. Chief Points, though, has been caught by Blind Turkey. He's dead keen. And Chief Points now going 1v3. Raps arrives, though, to help him out there. Picks up a kill on the Orianna. And now they are shepherding some minions to the first Nexus turret. LeBlanc has to stay out of range there. His Tormented Soil kept on getting the turret aggro off of him, but that's the first Nexus turret going down. 23 and a half minutes. Blind Turkey flashes. Oh, he flashes to get the root. And it wasn't even a root because the black shield onto Morgana mitigated the CC thoroughly. And with 28 kills to 6 right now, what is the score? The gold lead now, it is stretching to almost 20k. So it's it's still 17 at the moment.
Hey, 28 kills to 6 is probably better than 22 to 3.
Eight turrets, that's a better score, right? Yeah. And what do we have? We've got... I wonder if the Maokai is in a race with the Graves to reach double-figure deaths.
Oh, my God.
I mean, that's no BM. I'm not, like... It's quite obvious that something has been going on to... They've kind of thrown in the towel, I think. Luch has just disconnected, and this is a little bit of a worry, Longinus, because in the start of the game, we had that big delay for Champion Select because Luch got DC'd.
No, that wasn't Luch. That was Raps.
Oh, it was Raps. That's right. Oh, so
yes,
the infection so is
less of a worry, thankfully. All right. Well, let's take it. Oh, he looks like he's coming back.
Hey, while we have the pause going on, let's have a quick look at the situation in the other, in the bronze final that is going on right now. And that's between, Ormentor. I think it's Ormentor is the name of the team.
Okay.
And Halal Snack Pack. And they're busy having a team fight right now. It's 12-6 in kills in favor of the Halal Snack Pack boys, and they have a 7,000 gold lead. We're back into action here on the Rift in the grand final between John Howard and Sapphire, and John Howard's looking to cement their victory, much like the Liberals these days have over Labour. Complete domination.
We'll see how that goes in the next election. You know, all this switching of prime ministers couldn't be good for them. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. As Abyss Luch and Mediocre Jungler pressure mid LeBlanc, who I keep getting confused because the champion name is the name coming up. They're running out the front door with
coming
on the
through.
Hunt.
Yeah, from the boys in red, Sapphire, who are blue. That is blue. Blind Turkey, for once, hasn't just died at the start of it. He gets a couple of roots off there, but now the kills start coming through with Chief Points picking up a kill just to punctuate the double kill from the Lucian. And now the ace goes down. Surely that is game. They don't even have to take down any more inhibitors. They've got the one dead. And now the Nexus turret completely demolished. And Raps dashing forward and then flashing off of the stairs just for a bit of shenanigans. And game number one in convincing fashion going to John Howard.
Absolutely. I thought that was a good engage from Sapphire at the end there, but it just didn't matter when they were this far behind. There's no way to actually win a fight, even though they blew up Luch immediately. Just too far behind.
Well, that was the thing. They only had one murder in them. And after that, they were completely spent. Now, while that's been happening, we've had the raffle.
They needed to back out, yeah.
The raffle going on.
Yes,
so
we have.
We had a total of only 5 entries. So a 1 in 5 possibility to win. So how do I do this? So I close the raffle and then I draw the winner. And Do Not Tumble Dry is the winner of the raffle. He's been following the stream for all of today.
Nice.
That's very well done. So shout out to Do Not Tumble Dry. I'll just write that name down. And while I'm writing that down, Lon, do you want to talk about an MVP?
MVP. Ooh, yes. It has to be Mediocre Jungler. That at least play really, really on point. Set up Chief Points to succeed, set up Luch to succeed. It was just really, really, really good. The Elise pick, you have to play aggressive early. You have to get your lanes going, and that's exactly what he did. Granted, he took a lot of those kills, but he then used that gold to snowball other lanes even more. So, can't hate. got to give it to Mediocre Jungler.
All right, happy for it to go to Mediocre Jungler. And a quick correction, it is Do Not Tumblr Dry, who is the one
Tumblr Dry
won his ticket, the Razor Goliathus. We'll have a second raffle in game number two, ladies and gentlemen, which we'll be back in back within just a couple of minutes as we get the setup going. And that raffle is going to be for a Razor Hammerhead. So make sure we get more than five entries into it. We will be having a very quick break. Make sure that you cross over to Aussie Gaming TV or just have it open in multitwitch.tv so that you can keep an eye on how the bronze final is going while we're in that break and setting up for game number two of the grand final of the AGGN Open LoL tournament between John Howard. What?
Oh, it's been crossed out. Games TV 2. Yeah. Games to TV 2 doesn't.
There
it
you
deleted
go.
The link, the bot. Games to TV 2 didn't have permission to post links.
Over aggressive bot. Well, we'll be back in just a couple of minutes, ladies and gentlemen, with game number two of the grand final. Stay with us as we have a short break during the setup of that match.